Okay, 51 points on the Nifty. We've got 10,800. As Ashwini pointed out, for those of you, if you heard Ashwini, his point of view was those of you who are getting in and going long Nifty above 10,800, it could be a trap. The market is a little flatter to deceive going forward. It isn't exactly going to take away and run with it on the higher side. That's not going to happen, according to Ashwini. Okay, just a couple of sectors which are in action. So on the upside, you got the Nifty real estate. If you can put these intradays up 1.9% higher. You got the auto index, which is doing very well, 1.6%. We got the sales numbers for last month earlier this week, and they've been super strong again. So it's showing up in auto index. I think it should be one of the top gainers over the last 5 days, Friday to Friday. Energy is up about 1.2%, and you got the metal index, which is up about 0.9%. So metals, energy, auto, real estate, top of the list in terms of what is higher. The only large sector which is down is IT, and that too just under 0.25%. So nothing meaningful going on there. IT and pharma actually both are down, but you know, very small. Sunil Subramaniam is CEO of Sundaram Mutual Fund, and he's joining us right now in our studios. Sunil, thanks very much. Before we hit air, I was telling you, I was hoping, and I think you were also hoping, that we'd have the June mutual fund inflow numbers, but we don't have it. But since we don't have it, let me get your sense on how, would it be wildly different as compared to May, June?
I can speak about our counters. We've seen that the net inflows in this month are at about 95% of the previous month. Okay. So there's a small 5% month-on-month drop. but otherwise, I would say, that still indicates that the investors are still holding strong, because a 5% move is not really a big one because of the elevated levels at which the numbers themselves are. So I think a 5%.
So I think we got in the month of May, the number was about 12,000 crores.
Correct.
I mean, April was also 12,000 odd crores, so it was flat.
Correct.
You think we'd be somewhere in the vicinity of
we think it'd be
between 11 and 12.
So I'll tell you, trend-wise, what's happening in the flows is that SIPs continue to remain strong. It's at about 7,000 crores. So out of this 12,000 crores, which is net, 7,000 crores is SIP. Yeah. So the net flows, SIPs are dominating. But if you see the gross, my good sense is that the gross numbers would be about 30,000 crores, with redemptions of about 18,000 crores. Right? So out of 30,000 crores, you're getting 7,000 crores in SIP.
Okay.
So it's only about 25% of the market flows are the SIPs. Okay. But in net, its composition is naturally much higher. And there's been no deceleration in the SIP flows.
Okay.
So it means people's basic confidence in terms of that is strong.
And that you can see from your fund as well. You said
the other move which is we are seeing is that the in the balanced fund category, there should be a very strong difference. If you take Jan, Feb, March and earlier months, right, about 70% of the flows used to be in the dividend option of balanced funds and about 30% only in the growth. So what we have seen is because of the dividend distribution tax, right, so the people who've been recommending them to put it in dividend because it's a tax element to it has come down. So dividend option flows have come down, but it's been compensated by some rise in the growth option because balance is seen as a good product in volatile times. So while there's been probably a 20 to 30% drop in the dividend option flows, there's a 10 to 15% rise in the, so balanced as a category has dropped in its allocation, but that's not, the story is that there's a move to safety in the growth side of the thing, but there's a drop because of the taxation impact on the dividend option of balanced funds.
Okay.
So,
but in absolute numbers, balanced is, it'll be about 25, 26, I mean, under 3,000 crores, you would say?
Yeah, it was much higher earlier. No?
It used to be 7,000 odd crores, 7,700 crores. But now in June also, it'll be around 3,000 odd crore number.
Sunil, since we're talking about flows with this entire trade tariff issue which is playing out now, do you think that it'll impact incremental FII flows? I know we're in negative terrain in any case, but will it impact fresh flows at all?
See, FII flows are very sensitive to two, three things, right? One is interest rate scenario, which is in turn linked to the inflationary scenario, which is in turn linked to the revival of growth in America, right? So to the extent these tariffs, you know, could have a double-edged sword, you know, while it's good from a rhetoric perspective and there may be something, but it's not really good for the American economy, right? Tariff, because American economy depends on certain number of imports for it to grow. If these are going to hurt those imports. So I would say it's a bit iffy, that's one. Second is the dollar strengthening. Right, FII flows are also sensitive to the fact that commodity-oriented markets had taken away the flows from commodity-sucking markets like India. But with this tariff kind of a thing happening, flows could again reverse away from commodity back to countries like India. So I would actually say this whole, how the way this tariff will play out in terms of flows is still not easily predictable to say that higher the tariff, no, more negative on India. And actually, if you see longer term, and I think I said this in the last time I was here, the actual play out of this whole tariff war, one of the beneficiaries could be India.
Yeah.
Because ultimately, why should the American consumer play more? Mm. Because Trump wants to win a psychological battle with the Chinese and play to the elections. Ultimately, if these tariffs are dumped on them, the imports from China are going to be costlier for the American people. So it will translate into higher inflation and every American consumer paying more for the product that he is using.
Just to take that point forward with regards to India, we do have IT exports, we do have pharmaceutical exports. Do you think that Trump, there is a fear that, you know, Trump could probably act against these imports into the U.S. simply because he wants to try and be more protectionist? And in that sense, would you change your portfolio in anticipation of such a risk?
Not necessarily. We don't think IT is going to suffer in the tariff war because what is Trump trying to do, right? Mm-hmm. We know it's the November elections where he's trying to get the American consumer to think, make America great again. He's putting a very strong image about himself. IT is not something which translates into the American consumer at the ground level. In IT, the issue was with H-1B visas, all of that action is over. But in terms of, there's no tariff on IT imports or services. It's the goods related.
All right, Sunil, I think we need to cut across to Arijit Basu of SBI. He's talking on Vijay Mallya.